Good morning, everyone. On behalf of our management and Department of Science and Humanities, I welcome you all for the webinar on life skills. Your winner is someone who recognizes his God-given talents, works his tail off to develop them into skills, and uses these skills to accomplish his goals, said Larry Bird, the former American basketball player. Dear students, every one of us are bestowed with skills and knowledge, but most often they remain hidden and unrecognized. We at times need a stimulus to uncover them and channelize them in right direction for effective use. Today, we have with us an expert from corporate world to highlight the essential skills required to emerge successful in both personal and professional fronts. Let us lend our ears and create a niche for ourselves. May I now invite Dr. Azad Mohammed, Associate Professor, Department of Aeronautical Engineering, to introduce our guest, Mr. Satyanarayanan.
Thank you, ma'am. It gives me immense pleasure in introducing our chief guest, who is Associate Director at Cognizant Technology. We welcome you, sir, Mr. Satyanarayanan, sir. He started his career, I think he did his BE in mechanical engineering. And after that, he has been started his career as a supply chain architect, after which he has been involved with two major companies, that is Infosys Technologies. I think he was there for around 9 years. And then he's also been associated with Oracle and Accenture for about 3 or 4 years. There each, and latest he is also now presently is working as associate director at Cognizant Technologies. I think it's a great honor for us to be listening to such an eminent personality, and he has also chosen a topic on life skills, which I think is very much essential for the students. So I welcome you, sir, and I hope I don't want to take much of a time because I think we need to stick to them. We want to hear more from you. So thank you, and the stage is all yours.
Thank you very much, Azad. Thank you very much, madam. It is indeed a pleasure from my side also. I said, I already tried to be selfish. So I said, the pleasure of speaking to all of you is mine, basically. So I'm hoping you're able to see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Perfect. So thank you for that wonderful introduction as well. As a part of this session, I was kind of wondering, what do I put on the agenda? Okay, so in my college, I also used to attend such a seminar. Rightfully said, I am also an engineer, and I used to say proudly that I am a Royal Mechanical Engineering, right? So that's how we used to call. Is my video also present? For some reason, I think video is not present. You can share your video when you're done screen sharing. Oh, I think it can do only one of them. Let me try my hands again. It switches off my video. That's okay. So I was also going through all these seminars when I was in my college days, right? So I was wondering, what do I put on the agenda? Primarily, when I was in college, we used to have this face-to-face session more than a Zoom session or virtual sessions, right? So we college used to give us a tea and a couple of cookies, a butter biscuit in those times. So that was the key motivator for us to attend those sessions. Unfortunately, that motivator has also gone now because it's all virtual, right? So you have to arrange your own tea or coffee and butter biscuit now. So now the agenda has to take a very important role, right? So it can't just be the tea and butter biscuit. So at least when my time was there, there was not much of internet world. So we could at least Google, and people who were doing Google were considered great, right? So now you people are born with technology. So there is not much I can take from Google also to put it on the life skills or the agenda. So what I wanted to do, right? So I thought, okay, let me talk about latest technologies that are coming up, reading more or being more active in class and all that, right? So obviously, if I do that, you're already on mute and don't share your video. So you would put it away and then go away, right? So, and I'm anyway not doing that. Why? Because you have qualified professors. We already spoke about, we already spoke to Azad, Dr. Jaya, Bindu ma'am, etc. So they're all present who are more capable and more qualified than I am to talk about all this. So idea is basically to talk about simple life skills that we possibly know. I should say not even possibly, already know, but then we are kind of ignoring, right? So it is about those points that I would like to share. It does not matter which stream that we have picked up in engineering or which area of work that we want to do. This is all simple basic life skills that all of us should ideally know. All of us know, but then don't even follow it, right? So that is where it is. So what I did is I have a slide which says that let's start with a famous personality that you have in mind. Okay, so who is your favorite personality or somebody who has inspired? If you can tell me that person, anybody can unmute yourself and tell me who that person is. What is the relationship with that person? Could be a friend, could be a lecturer, or could be a teacher in school. Possibly could be your parents, could be your relative, or it could be somebody like Abdul Kalam, whom we have kind of no relationship with, but we think them as a mentor, right? People like that. And why do you think that person is a famous personality or your favorite personality? And I've put four slots. I would request somebody to unmute and possibly four of you to answer this question. Who is your favorite personality? What is your relationship and why? Can anybody unmute and let me know, please? Nobody?
Fatima has raised her hand.
Yes, ma'am. Please go ahead. I am not able to see that hand being raised. Yes, Fatima.
So students, now your mic has been enabled. You can now unmute and speak.
Kalpana Chawla. Kalpana Chawla, okay.
Ratan Tata.
Okay. Ratan Tata.
Sir, Nikola Tesla.
Oh, okay. Tesla, okay.
Elon Musk, sir.
Okay, I was expecting that gentleman. Okay. All right, so forget, apologies on the font, okay? Now you tell me, we know what the relationship with we have with these people, right? So why do you think they are your favorite personality?
Because...
Yes, ma'am, because?
Yeah, because she has gone through so many hardships to reach into space. From, you know, how her journey from India to USA to NASA.
Got it. Can I say this way?
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Somebody who said Ratan Tata?
Yes, sir.
Why would you think Ratan Tata is your favorite person?
He keeps a good relation with his employees and as well as his investors.
Okay, fantastic. Very true. Good point. Thank you very much. Tesla?
Sir, in spite of rejections, he came up with many ideas like bringing free electricity, finding infinite charge battery, and many of such things, sir.
Okay. Very true, very true. And there used to be a what do you call, a lot of tug of war between Tesla and a lot of people who stayed in that period of time. I can understand what you're saying. Thank you very much. Somebody who said Elon Musk.
So because of his future ideas and his way of thinking towards future.
Okay. Okay, futuristic ideas. Okay, thank you for that. Which is why I rightfully started saying Iron Man, right? It is possibly true. So thanks for sharing that. So let's keep these four people handy. I will possibly stop my screen share now and come on video so I can, at least you will look at me when I'm talking, right? So Yeah, so before I get into this, the actual session, right, I wanted to get your favorite personality, at least four of them on board, so we can connect to them when we talk, right? So one last question that I want to ask you is, what is the most sore thing in the world, okay? If I have to say in Tamil, kasappana vishayam enna? You keep thinking, I will tell you the answer because you're not going to. Okay, well said, well said. I was also coming somewhere there. It is quite philosophical. The most sore thing in the world is advice, according to me. And that too, when it comes from a person whom you have never met before and you're not going to meet, right? Advice seems very sore. So I am trying as much as possible not to advise you guys. But if I did seem that way, then don't blame me. Blame my gray beard, okay? It's because of my age that I tend to advise. So that is how it is. Now let's get to what I wanted to say, okay? Let's say that I know you all like cars and bikes and all that, right? Let's say if I give you 1 crore worth of awesome bike, okay, so 18 geared bike or absolute gold plated BMW cars that you see on Facebook, etc. Right? Let's assume that I give you one such vehicle as gift. Would you ever put junk into that vehicle? Meaning that instead of petrol, would you want to fill it with kerosene or something else and try driving? Would you ever do that? Or if would you drive it so rash that you hit somebody or you go so close to somebody and then go? If you drive that vehicle, you will kind of surrounded by an aura, right? You don't want people to come. So keep looking at, is anybody coming near my vehicle or somebody's touching my vehicle, right? How much would you take care of that vehicle? Right? Now, if you compare that vehicle, all it is doing is basically taking you from point A to point B, as simple as that. Right? When it is that way, now for all good reasons, all of us have been blessed with a wonderful body, okay? Of course, we would say that, okay, I'm short, dark, tall, fat, lean, whatever we have to say, but we are still given a vessel as a body which is more, million times more than what that car or vehicle is. But what do? We end up absolutely abusing that body, right? We put junk inside. We don't surround ourselves with that aura. Are you touching me, etc. We go and mix with negative people. We take junk inside. I'm not saying don't eat pasta and pizza. I'm saying don't fill yourself with junk, right? So we all do that. We take our body to the extreme. We go to the stage of going and getting crashed somewhere. Why do we do that? Is because we don't consider our body as that important a vehicle as a materialistic car or a bike or whatever, right? So if you look at it, all the people whom you have said, be it Ratan Tata, Elon Musk or whoever, Tesla or Kalpana Chawla, their goal is something else. I want to travel to space. I want to invent something. I want to get a rocket that can come back, right? Reusable launch pads or reusable vehicle parts, rocket parts. Now they are able to do all that because they are able to take care of their particular vessel or their body very well. You can think Sachin Tendulkar was hitting centuries at 40 while I could be possibly suffering with knee pain at 40, right? Not even able to walk around. Now what is the point? Forget I have futuristic ideas. I want to do something else. I am going to help people. I want to treat everybody well. But at the end of the day, my body is not cooperating. What do you think will be my priority? Of course, we can talk about people who are on wheelchair and who are still talking about space. But then we just have one example like that, right? You know whom I'm talking about. I leave you guessing if you don't know. So the question is, body is something that we should certainly take care of. Only then would you be able to do anything. Think of Ratan Tata and his age, right? We have our grandparents or our parents who are 40 and who are in their 60s, etc., who are basically struggling with back pain, struggling with arthritis, who are sitting there and possibly not able to help themselves. Why? I'm not saying everybody ignore their health, but there are people who do ignore, at least at this age where you are. Health is the first thing that we ignore. And in the time of COVID, COVID doesn't kill everybody it catches, right? It only kills people who are not able to fight COVID internally. So ideally, body is the first thing that we should take care of, right? That's the first piece of thing that I wanted to tell you. Don't call it an advice. I would possibly call it a tip, but remember that. Okay. Second thing is, I would like to tell a story. Okay. So once there was a plane that was a perfect plane. Okay. So it was carrying a monkey in a cage and was supposed to go from one place to another. And once that plane started, it started very well. It was comfortably going, even though it had rough weather, it was all going fine. Okay. But before it reached the destination, suddenly the plane crashed in a forest and almost everybody died. Okay. So when people came there and started finding what all is available, etc., they found only this monkey was alive. The rest of all people were dead. Lucky thing is that the monkey was kind of intelligent. Okay. So it was trained to do certain things or respond to human in a way that people can understand via sign language. So people started questioning that monkey and tried to see what happened. Okay. Initial investigation. So they said, there were people guarding you, right? What did they do? They said that the monkey signaled them. They were having a gun and they were standing. They said, fine. But what were they doing when the plane hit? Then the monkey was saying. So people knew that the people who were supposed to take care of the monkey were actually drinking and having fun. They did not take care of the monkey. They said, okay, fine. That is accepted. What were the pilots doing when the plane started? So the monkey said like this. So then people understood, okay, people were driving. Then they asked, what did those pilots do when the plane crashed? Then the monkey said this. Then people knew that these pilots were basically sleeping. Then they said, what were you doing when the plane started? Then it said, I was standing in a cage like this. Then they asked, what did you do when the plane was crashing? Then that monkey said like this. Then people understood it was the monkey that was driving the plane. Right? So ideally, if you let a monkey drive a plane, this is what will happen. It will crash. Now, analogically speaking, there is a monkey here. If you let that monkey drive this plane, you are bound to crash. Right? So that's one of the important things. Now, I will tell you a scenario which you might have experienced, okay? We all study just before the exam as much as we can, right? On the day of exam, exam was at 10 o'clock and we all start preparing voraciously in the morning. We will sleep at night thinking, boss, I'm getting up and these two chapters I have to complete tomorrow, no other go. You tell your mother, father or your sibling to say, boss, wake me up at 4 o'clock. I am studying this chapter. Please, it is important. People have told it will come. But next day morning when the alarm rings on your phone, you would possibly take your hand out of your bedsheet and say, five more minutes. Right? After your mother has given up because you are not getting up, she tells your father, boss, can you be a little strict to him or her? He is not, they are not getting up. Can you go and tell? This time, because of respect, you take your bedsheet out and then say 5 more minutes till it is actually very late. How has this scenario happened to you before? Sorry, somebody wants to say something. Right, so Arun?
It's a disturbance. You can continue.
Sorry, I was also muted. So I'm hoping that this would have happened to you. And at least this happened to me and my siblings. So we do that. And at the end of the day, we get up late and we look at the watch and saying, come on, it's only 1 mark to the exam. I have not even read this chapter, which they are saying it 16 mark question will certainly come. I should have read. Right? We have done this. So if you look at it and you go and do bad in the exam, then who is it to be blamed? Is it your mother who was not strict enough to wake you up? Or is it your father who did not wake you up in the first place with a strict voice? Or is it possibly your brother or sister who did not kick you before, right? If you look at it, the actual culprits or whoever messed it up is us. Why? Because we were letting the monkey drive our brain. And the monkey is driving, it wants to say, go and sleep. Right? Now, this problem is not typical to just people who are in college, right? people who are at work. Now, I am an associate director at Cognizant. I also sometimes face this problem. There used to be a joke, okay? A mother is coming and waking up a son saying, boss, go to college. And he's saying, ma, 5 minutes. Then he says, boss, time is up, you should go. Then the son says, can you tell me 2 valid reasons why I should go to college today? So mother basically says, I have been doing this for last so many years and you have not changed. At least for that reason, get up and go to college. And second reason is you are the principal of the college, for heaven's sake, go. Right? So while it is a joke, it is true. All of us sometimes let that monkey drive our brain and we kind of forget. So all the people that we have seen, right, say Kalpana Chawla or anybody, all our people, are basically people who have the same monkey in their brain, just that they don't let that monkey loose, right? They never let that monkey drive. Okay, that is one of the important things that we should keep in mind. Never ever let a procrastination or a monkey basically drive what we want to do. Next point I wanted to tell is, before I do this, anybody who gives a session to a college or school kids, right, should talk about one important personality. Yeah, Azad, you wanted to say something?
Okay.
So I was just asking a question saying if anybody who talks to college students or school students, right, they have to talk about one important personality. Who is that person?
HOD.
Good guess. I would love to say that, but it's not a HOD. I was about to talk about APJ Abdul Kalam, sir. Now, anybody who talks to college or school students or somebody who is studying, Abdul Kalam, sir, is something that you should touch. So I am also touching that topic. I am talking about a story that Dr. Abdul Kalam himself said somewhere. So he was delivering a lecture to a set of college students, and he was basically asking, why do you think Aishwarya Rai won that competition when she took that Miss World or Miss Universe title? What do you think is the reason that she won? So many of the college students raised their hands and started saying a lot of points. Okay, maybe she looked beautiful. The way she conducted herself was very good. There were other contestants who were not as polished as her or as posh as how she is. The people started saying she groomed herself well. Some people said she answered those questions, right? They asked those questions. She answered them intelligently, etc. There is one particular lady who got up and said that she won because I did not participate. Right? So the idea is that forget if you are that capable of going and winning a prize or a contest. Okay. The first thing that we should remember is the confidence. So I've never even done research saying who that lady is and how she looked, but look at that confidence, right? I am not there, which is why Aishwarya Rai won. So she is able to bring that confidence out as a person, right? So that is something sometimes we lack. We have, all of us, I would say, generally have a problem with these things. Self. Okay, that's the first point. Like, am I too short for this? Am I too tall for this? Am I too fair for this? I'm too dark for this? Am I intelligent enough to study or crack this exam, etc.? Right? So it's all self problems that I have these problems. I'm sometimes lazy. I get angry. I get jealous, etc. So there are problems this way. Second is that you would have problems with the family. There are people who keep discouraging you, right? So there's an uncle who keeps saying, yeah, I know that guy. He will always do this, right? So there are people who will do that. So if we expand that a little more, it is possibly a society. You have your neighbor and you have other people who are always constantly talking something negative about you. So these are problems that you will always have, okay? Next is possibly the educational institution or a college or wherever you're working. Sometimes that will also demean you and then not help. These are the general 4 problems that we'll have with anybody, okay? You classify any person who's creating a problem, they would possibly fit in either of those 4. Okay, so all of us face these problems, not just you. That is where I'm saying that the confidence that you exhibit, the confidence that you have is what is going to kill all these people and kill all the comments that are coming in. Right, so that is the third point. I would always say that have confidence, self-confidence. The Sachin Tendulkar and Brian Lara were possibly the shortest people, and they are still considered god of cricket, isn't it? So never look at the negative things. Be confident enough, and I'm sure that you should be able to achieve. Okay. Next point that I wanted to share is about Usain Bolt, right? You all know that he is a lightning bolt and the fastest man alive, right? So that person, when did he become a champion? Okay. When do you think Usain Bolt became a champion? I'll put that question to you because I've been talking for like last few minutes. Let me put that question back to you now. When do you think Usain Bolt became famous, or he became a champion?
Sir, when he practiced for 18 hours a day.
Certainly. Very good. Very good. That is the right answer. Okay. I was hoping that somebody would ideally tell that. Now, if it was all a matter of running, right? All of us also run. So he did not win when he was running full fast, or he did not win when he stood on the podium and raised his hands, right? He won the game in the thousands of hours of practice when all others were sleeping. When he was running at 5 a.m. in the morning when the rest of the world was sleeping, that is where he won that competition. That is where he became a champion. If you look at it, I'm not saying that being first in the college is all that is going to help you, but it is certainly a qualification that we should have, isn't it? That is all why we have joined the college, to achieve, learn knowledge out of this, to achieve a degree that we can put it on our resume. Right. If you look at it, every single thing in our life can be stolen. Even the health can be taken away from us, right, as we grow old. Degrees is something that once you earn is going to remain with you. Right. So if it is all a matter of sitting and writing exam for 3 hours and that is how you became college first or you get a degree, then that is wrong. All of us are writing, right? But why do some people fail? Why do some people become toppers? The reason is the champions are not made there, right? It is made when people are sitting and studying. It is made when nobody is watching and you're still going through the books, right? That is when the champions are made, ideally. Right? So I would always say that forget what others are saying. Put your hard work. 200% of work should definitely be there. Right? Now, I would ask you one more question. Oh, this also is a scenario you would have seen in... when you're driving, okay? There are times when you're driving and there is somebody who is going at full speed past you, like zoom, and that person almost hits you, right? You tell the person who is sitting at the back saying, what a crazy driver, see how he's driving, right? What a stupid fellow. You would have certainly told that. But at the same time, possibly in the same journey itself, when you are trying to go past a person who is very slow, you would tell the person at the back saying, see, look at that fellow, what is he driving? If he wants to drive at 10 kilometer speed, let him drive in a corner. Why is he blocking others' way? Right? You would have told the same thing possibly in the same journey to a person when you're driving a car or a two-wheeler. I'm hoping you have a license and you're still driving. Okay. So this would happen. Now, why does this happen? Now, when you look at from the other person's perspective, right? A person who zoomed past you, right? Full speed. What would that person be saying? That he will say, if you want to drive slow, why are you blocking my way? Why can't you go in a corner? Right? And at the same time, when you zoom past somebody scolding, they are very slow, that person would be scolding you saying, why the hell are you driving so fast? Why can't you go slow? What is a big hurry, right? So why it happens is that we always look things from our perspective. And sometimes life is like a highway, right? So it is not that you need to go and reach that destination next second. Possibly enjoy that journey, right? That is what we do. Now, if you look at it, you may cribble a lot about your college and all those things, but when you come out, this possible wonderful life that you have of college life is certainly lost. So I would say that you should enjoy the college life as much as you can and forget what each others are saying, right? What other people are saying and how what other people think of you. People travel the college, I should say life, the way and the speed in which you want it, not what other people want it. Now, why I am saying this is because I am certainly 22 years out of college. Now I can certainly say this. A person who sat in the very first bench, right, and possibly who scored the first mark in the class, when I speak to him, he's saying, what a wonderful college life we had, right? When I talk to the person who is sitting in the very last bench, and who possibly did not listen to lecture half the time, he did not come to class, but he somehow got a degree, is also saying the same thing. Man, what a college life I had. It was wonderful, right? And he is asking me when I am possibly sitting somewhere between both of them, right? Now, enjoyment or how you want to lead a life is completely up to us. And people are traveling in that highway, as I told you, in the highway of college in different speeds. One person wants to go fast, one person wants to go slow. You are too fast for somebody or you're too slow for somebody. And that will always continue to happen. So do not think that others' perspective or others' focus is required. So focus on your own perspective, your own goal, right? So that's one of the key things that I wanted to share. This at least happened to me. One point I wanted to next talk about is there was a person who was an artist, okay? He used to draw a lot of, what do you call, comics in magazines. Okay, he is called Gopu. Now, what happens is he at that time when there was no internet and all those things, magazines were the only things, and he was drawing a lot of cartoons. And what happened is that when during his peak of his career, right, when he was the maximum hit, unfortunately, he had a paralytic attack and he could not move one side of his body. And unfortunately, it happened that his right side hand was severely affected. And he could not even grab a pen, forget writing or drawing. Okay, so people were thinking that there was absolutely no way that he would he's going to come out of this mess. Right? People were thinking that more than physically, not able to draw or not able to do what he thinks is going to kill that person. At least psychologically, that is what people were thinking. But during one of the interviews, that person sounded very positive. You know what he said? He said that I used to take a pencil and draw strokes. Now God has taken his own pencil and he has drawn a stroke on my hand. Right? You call a paralytic attack a stroke, right? Now think of the positive approach that he had, right? See how he took it. Now he is comparing himself to a God in first place. Second, he is saying that just like how I create a drawing, no, God has created a drawing in me. It means that you would never say a drawing is perfect or bad, etc., right? It's a piece of art. So God has also done a piece of art and I am a piece of art myself, which is what he is philosophically saying, right? So that is the positive approach that we should always have in mind. Now, all of I've told you that all of us have worries and problems, etc. Remember, I was saying there are four things. So it could be a self, it could be a school or a college, it could be a family, or it could be a society. Now, either way you go, these are the people you can classify. You call a friend, a relative, etc. People will anyway fit in this four point, right? So there will be people who talk negative. But the idea is there is one proverb that I learned, okay? When you're walking on a street or going on a park, etc., you can never prevent a bird that is flying on top of your head, right? There might be a bird that keeps flying on top of your head. How long will you do shoot? Possibly it is running. Sorry.
You continue. You need to unmute, sir. You are unmute.
Oops, sorry for that. I was busy explaining and talking to myself. So I was saying that if a bird is flying on top of your head, there is not much you can do. It's possibly dying, flying low, or it's possibly flying 2-3 kilometers above your head. There is nothing much you can actually do. But if you let that bird come and sit on top of your head, build a nest, put eggs, hatch those eggs and build a life there, then you would become a fool, isn't it? You would never wait that long. Looks very funny, but it does happen. I'll tell you how. Now compare that bird with a worry or a problem that you have, right? The four types of problem that I said will be with everybody. And that will keep flying on top of our head. It will come, it will be there for a little bit of time when it is flying over your head, and then it will go away. Right? There is one person who is talking negative about me at my college. He will be talking few years he will talk, or few weeks he will talk, months, say years also, 4 years he talks, but then he goes away, he flies and he moves to his own place. You can't throw that person away, or you can't shoo that person away, right? You can't say shoo. That person will be there anyway. But if you let that person sit on top of your head, take that person into your head, let him hatch eggs and keep building all the negative thoughts in your head, then that is something wrong. Don't we do that? Right? When we spoke about a bird, it looked very funny. But when we did talk about a person who's talking bad about us, it didn't look funny, because that is exactly what we do. Right? We let those thoughts come and sit on top of our head, lay eggs, hatch also. Right? That is all we do. Now, if I ask you this question, how many of you have faced problems in life, right? How many of you will say, yeah, I faced problem? How many said, no, my life so far has been good, right? If we take a survey, like there are a lot of people here. Now, if I take a survey, how would it be? Now, typically, this survey is the same result it will give when you're at school. This is the same result you will have at college. This will have same result when you're going to first few years of your life. Go and talk to all the associate directors, go and talk to all the vice presidents and CEO, you would still get the same survey, okay? All of us will say, yeah, I have some problems, yeah, I had happy parts of life, everything. But when you start asking a question, what problems you faced, right, in each of the survey, then the answer will be different. If you go to school, you would possibly say, my teacher did not let me go and play. My teacher did not let me take out a toy that I wanted, right? My mother did not buy me an ice cream. These are the biggest problems you would face in kindergarten. You go to high school, problems would have certainly changed. They would say that, they are making me read Max. I don't want to do Max. I want to become an artist. Why do I have to learn Max? Do I always have to have problems? There are so many problems in life, right? People keep cribbing. You come to college, you would start cribbing about Max in a different way. They are making me learn integral calculus, right? What does that has to do with being an engineer? Tell me which engineer is actually doing integral calculus in his 20 years of his career, right? You will start talking about hi-fi things. Now you go into college, you would possibly talk about a different set of problems. You will say, my boss never gave me leave. I ideally wanted to take one day Friday off and go to Pondicherry and have some fun with friends. Nothing is happening, right? But as you grow, the survey remains the same, be it school, college, your bachelor or spinster life, or you get married, or you even talk to 60, 70 year old people, the survey will be same. But the nature of problems in each of the phases will certainly change. Right? So that is how life is. So that is one of the key things that we should all keep in mind. So possibly these are the main points that I wanted to share with you. One last thing that I wanted to share is, like, how deeply are we associated with social media, right? So how many times do we keep carrying our phones everywhere we go? You get up in the morning and first thing you do is don't look at who's standing next, right? You go and search, where is my mobile, right? So when you're extremely hungry, even at that time, you're not that panicky. But when your phone is hungry and it is at 2% or 5% charge, right, you start becoming panicky. Oh, where is my phone? Where do I charge? Why current is not there, right? So while it is very nice to be connected in social media, talk to people instantly and all that, it is a double-edged sword. We just need to have those things very strongly in mind. Right? So those are the important things that I wanted to tell you. And that's possibly I have put it onto my slide also. I will share my screen just to reiterate whatever I have said. Right, so these are the important things. We spoke about how healthy we should keep our body, right? So we spoke about Kalpana Chawla, Elon Musk, and all those people. We certainly agreed that each of them are able to do and achieve what they want because they are. So if you look at Ratan Tata and his age versus you compare one of our grandmother or grandparents, then you would know that a healthy body is what is required to go and achieve your goal. right? Not just ambition. Now, all those people have certainly considered a very sound, strong and healthy body. Second is sound mind. Remember, all of us have that procrastinating monkey in our brain, but not all of us let that monkey drive the plane, right? Certainly not the four people that you have told. Kalpana Chawla, Elon Musk, and all those people could have taken a mediocre job and would have settled somewhere, right? But they didn't do that. They ran behind their vision and they let that procrastination monkey inside a cage. It is also present. You may have to have some fun. Those times you let the monkey run wild, which is okay. But most of the time, they did not let that monkey drive the plane and they ensured that you have a very strong and sound mind. Right? Next thing we saw is the confidence. How did the artist Gopu have the confidence, even though, he had a stroke? And how did that lady get up and say that, since I was not there, Aishwarya Rai won, right? So that is the confidence that we should basically have with ourselves. You have a strong mind, good focus, you have a healthy body to support what you do. Next is get that confidence. Next is hard work. I did speak about Usain Bolt, and there was a gentleman who rightfully nailed at the start of the question, saying that that person became a champion not when he went and raised his hands at the podium, but he, in the thousands of hours of practice and 5 a.m. run when everybody else was sleeping. That is where he became a champion. So put your hard work. Right? Last point is never worry. Like the highway story, somebody would call you are too fast, somebody would call you are too slow. But don't worry, you go, you have your focus, keep going in your pace. Right? At the same time, never let the bird sit on top of your head and lay eggs and hatch the chicks, right? So let that bird pass. It will be there and you can't stop that bird. So that is all I would say. One last point when I tell this point, you will know who told this in media. Whenever you have people who are troubling you, right, whoever it is, I would say that kill them with your success and burn and bury them with your smile. That's the best way to respond to people who are against you. I'll just close my topic with that point. Kill your enemies with your success and burn and bury them with your smile. Thank you very much. Azad, I would now leave this podium to you.
So let me take the opportunity, sir.
Please, ma'am.
Thank you, sir, for making the session interactive. Through storytelling and questioning, you made us realize the need to develop skills like self-confidence, hard work, putting oneself in someone else's shoes, positive attitude, of social media. On behalf of our students, I would like to tell you that they will not allow the monkey in them to drive their vehicle of life. Thank you once again, sir. Being told that you are appreciated is one of the simplest and most uplifting things you can hear. Appreciations can make your day, can even change a life. It is a greatest motivator. It had been a long wait. We were waiting for a befitting platform to recognize and appreciate our students who fared well in the 6-week foundation course conducted during August-September 2020. They are to be recognized for their full attendance and for the Build to Learn project submitted as a part of Python programming training. I now call upon Ms. Bindu, Head Department of Science and Humanities, to honor the meritorious students by announcing their names. E-certificates will be dispatched through emails shortly. Over to you, madam. I also request you to present the vote of thanks after the announcement. Bindu, ma'am.
Thank you, Jaya, ma'am. Hope I'm audible.
Yes, ma'am, you are.
All right, so as Dr. Zaya told, I'll be announcing two lists of students. So I start with the 100% attendance list. From computer science, Alfie Titus Anil, Deepak Rajkumar, R. Dinesh, Praveen Mahesh R., Ramavat, Shakti Murugan, Sharon Javana, V. N. Surya, Spurthi Patel, Suhas Sabari Girish, and Vail Murugan. From the Department of Information Technology, Bhaskar S.P., Kirti Varman, Rakesh Kumar, and S.K. Yuvaraj. From Artificial Intelligence and Data Science, Arvind Babu, Jovin John, Rai Pudel. Deepak from ECE, Ashwin RS and Rishi Vardhan from E&I, Aditya Sugavaneshwar and Shivam from Mechatronics, Ashwin Tien and K. Suvakumar from Mechanical, Kiran Babu from Automobile, Jan Emanuel from Civil, Devanand and Jonathan from Aeronautical, Balaji Adapalli, Shagul and Shruti Rajagopalan from Aerospace of Engineering branch. So these many students had attended all days in the 6 weeks course offered during the foundation course. Now let me read the students list, the students who had submitted projects on Build to Learn projects given during Python programming training. We have from computer science, Alfie Titus Anil, Anvin Sanju John, Asmita Sharon, Carolyn, Dinesh, Ibrahim Husefa, Shakti Murugan, Spurthi Patel, Uday Kumar, and Sharon Joanna. From IT, Belgian, B. Mohanapriya, Nina, and Vail Murugan. Fahima, Lokesh, and Nehamina from ECE. Arvind Babu, V.S. Darun, Mohammed Amil, Mohammed Zilani, S. Karthikeyan, and Sujitra from Artificial Intelligence and Data Science. Ashwin RS from E&I, Atharva Atul, Shruti Rajagopalan and Tivya Rani from Aerospace, Priscilla Maglin, A. Kirtika and Shailesh from Aeronautical, Kirti Rajan from Automobile, Mukesh Khanna from Mechanical, P. Jyotika from Fashion Technology and Sugavaneshwar from Mechatronics. My heartfelt congratulations to all of you. I also take this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks. First and foremost, I wish to place on records my sincere thanks to our management for their encouragement and support in conducting beyond curriculum activities for the benefit of our students. Next, I would like to thank our guest, Mr. Satyanarayan, for his insightful speech on life skills. I also thank our principal, Dr. G. Prabhakaran, and Associate Dean, Dr. Deva Sundari, for their guidance, which has been helping us in maintaining a right balance between academic and non-academic activities. My special thanks to Dr. Azad Ahmed, Associate Professor, Aeronautical Department, for his help in arranging the guest for today's program. I thank the members of faculty of Science and Humanities Department and all other departments for their cooperation in conducting this webinar today. Last but not the least, I once again congratulate the achievers and appreciate all my students here for having been a wonderful audience. Thank you, one and all. So with this, we come to the end of the program, students. So you can take a break. And as mentioned, we will have the regular classes from second session onwards. So please join your respective classes by 10:45 today. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Have a fantastic day.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.